Hello everyone, welcome on this APEX Institute of Physics e-learning platform. I am Santosh Kumar, and in this video we will talk about Gauss law, and this is a very powerful law. So let's see what the statement is. The statement says the net flux. It talks about the net flux passing through. So let me write here, net flux passing through any closed surface is the product of the net charge enclosed and 1 upon epsilon naught. So in short, it says the net flux through any closed surface is the total charge enclosed inside that surface into 1 upon epsilon naught, which we can write as Q enclosed upon epsilon naught. So this is the statement of Gauss. The same statement mathematically can be written as the net flux, which is E dot ds. So we know E dot ds is the flux passing through any surface. And since it is demanding from a closed surface, so that means that surface has a closed integration. And we know, or you might be knowing, that this closed integration has a ring over here. That ring indicates the integration has to be performed over the entire closed surface. That means this integration is a definite integration. So this is the net flux through a closed surface. And this is equal to, as per the statement of Gauss, that total charge enclosed inside. So I'm writing it as a Q enclosed in short form. So that's a total charge enclosed inside divided by epsilon naught. So this is the mathematical representation of the Gauss law. So we can remember this. Now here are the terms that are involved. We need to know about those terms. Here there's a one left hand side and another right hand side. So let's try to understand what is in the left hand side. In totality, this left hand side is indicating the total flux, and right hand side is simply asking about Q enclosed upon epsilon naught. Now this is integration over the closed surface, as I have just told. And what E is here, E is indicating the field. So E indicates here electric field, vector of course. So that's the electric field vector. But where? So this electric field E is at location of ds vector. So at the location where the ds vector has been chosen, at that point it is the field. Now moreover, this field is due to, so that's an important point, this field is due to all the charges present. Now what the meaning of this all the charges present is, it is because of all the charges. That means whether the charges are inside the closed surface or outside the closed surface. And ds is a differential element that we know. So this left hand side is total flux passing through the closed surface. Whereas on the right hand side, another term that we are using is Q enclosed. This is counting only the net charge which is inside the closed surface. So that is net charge inside the closed surface. Now this can be better understood by this figure. So we have a figure over here. Let's talk about this figure. There are certain charge distribution, and that charges are scattered charges, let Q1, Q2, Q3 with the minus sign, Q4, Q5, minus Q6 and Q7. So there are several charges spread over here. And we have opted this closed surface. So that boundary line is indicating a closed surface. So we need to opt a closed surface. This closed surface is also known as Gaussian surface. Gaussian surface. So Gaussian surface is a closed surface that we can remember. Now if we perform this Gauss law over this charge distribution, so what we need to have, we need to write E and ds. So on this surface we will be choosing some element, that element will be having ds vector. So that's a ds, and at this particular location we need to find what the field is. So field is at this particular location. So we will be doing the dot product of these two vector quantities, then we will be integrating over the entire closed surface. So this will be left hand side. Now we have just written down over here that E is the field because of all the charges. That means this field is because of Q1, Q2, minus Q3, Q4, Q5, minus Q6 and Q7. That means whether the charges are inside or outside, all the charges collectively producing this field. Right, and whereas this Q enclosed, that means a right hand side aspect, Q enclosed, this is in counting only the charge which is inside this boundary. Now we can see from this picture the charges inside are Q1 minus Q3 and Q5. So here on the right hand side we will be writing Q enclosed as Q1 minus Q3 plus Q5. So we need to write all the charges which is inside, we need to add them up according to their signs. So Q1 and then minus Q3 and then plus Q5. So whenever we are writing this right hand side, we are not using the charges which are lying outside. So right hand side contains only those charges which is inside the Gaussian surface, whereas the field on the left hand side is because of all the charges. So this is the statement of Gauss, and here is the meaning of the terms involved. This Gauss law is always true. This is always true. And we will be using this Gauss law for two purposes. One purpose will be to find out the flux through a closed surface or any part of it. So calculation of flux can be done using the Gauss law. Moreover, this Gauss law can also be used to find out the electric field due to a particular symmetrical or due to some symmetrical charge distributions. So in case of symmetrical charge distributions, we will be able to use this Gauss law to find out the electric field. So these two purposes we are going to use. So we will see in the next part the uses of this Gauss law. Okay, so let's go ahead.
Well, as an example of flux calculations, so there is a question. So it says find the flux due to a point charge located at the center of the cube, and cube is shown here. So that's a point charge at the center point, and you might be asked the questions related to the flux. So let's take one part of it, and it says flux passing through, the flux that we need to find which is passing through the cube. Passing through the cube. So how much the flux will pass through a cube? And so if we need to solve this this part, so what we can do is, like, we can find out the total flux, and total flux is integration E dot ds. Now we can go for the integration using value of E and ds, and then solving it is going to be complicated. But we know this cube is going to form a closed surface. Since it can be formed as a closed surface, so we can say this is a Gaussian surface. So this closed integration will lead to integration over the closed surface. And as per the Gauss law, we know this number is equal to simply the charge inside upon epsilon naught. And from this picture, we can easily watch what the charge inside is. And the charge inside is simply Q divided by epsilon naught. So that becomes our answer. That means the net flux passing through this cube is going to be Q upon epsilon naught. If you have followed the previous videos, in one of the video we have calculated the charge because of the flux because of a point charge. So total flux comes out to be Q upon epsilon naught. The same thing is dictated by or said by the Gauss. Alright, so this part we can easily handle. Let's say we can have another question, or the part of the question that says the flux we need to find that is passing through one face of the cube, or let's say passing through top face of the cube. Now again, to find the flux, we either we can proceed like this. The flux is going to be integration E dot ds, and we can use the mathematics behind it. But again, this the mathematics is going to be very difficult. So here we can use a symmetry. What the symmetry we can use? This point charge is located at the center, and we know the field lines are symmetrical from that point. So for a particular solid angle, they are particular value, right? So if we are interested in finding the flux through this top surface, let's say, so we can say the number of field lines passing through the top surface is going to be same as the number of field lines passing through the bottom surface, and similarly that number will be same for all other faces. Since we know the total flux is Q upon epsilon naught, and each face will have equal share, and there are six faces of a cube that we know, that means this flux that we are interested in from one face, it is going to be 1/6 of the total, and total flux is Q upon epsilon naught. So that becomes our answer, right? So using the symmetry, we can call any face of the cube will have same flux, which is Q upon 6 epsilon naught. So using Gauss law and symmetry, we can answer the flux, net flux through the cube, or the flux through any of the part or any of the face of the cube, right? So that's that is one of the example. We can have another example as well. Here is another example, and this example is find the charge this reads find the flux through following surfaces. We are going to write the surfaces from where we need to find the flux if the charge is located at this corner. So at this corner the charge is being located. This is a cube, and we need to find the flux. So let's say first part is we need to find the flux through a cube, entire cube. Now, so this cube in itself is a closed surface, if we apply the Gauss law, we know this Gauss law is integration E dot ds, which is equal to E dot ds, which is equal to total charge enclosed upon epsilon naught. Now we choose Gauss law in such a way that the charge is not lying on the Gaussian surface. So point charge or discrete charge should not lie on the Gaussian surface. That's also one of the constraint, right? So because if the which I choose this cube as a Gaussian surface, so we will not be able to decide whether this charge is inside or outside. So we cannot apply Gauss law directly on this cube, and still we need to find the flux through the entire part. So we can say if we need to find the total flux because of the point charge, we know it's a Q upon epsilon naught. But what the part this Q will share, for that sake we can have a construction or imagination in such a way that this point charge becomes the center of a bigger cube. So let's construct a bigger cube of which this point charge or this corner becomes the center. To do so, we require this kind of cubes. And if you imagine, you need to have a four this kind of cubes located at the bottom and four upside. So if there are eight this kind of cubes, so this point will become the center, and you will have another cube of double the dimension. So if we consider that big cube, so the total flux will be Q upon epsilon naught because of a point charge. Now since we have used total eight this kind of cubes, and all the cubes are symmetrically located as per this charge is concerned, so all eight cubes will have equal share of flux. So the share of the flux of for this cube is going to be definitely 1/8. So this will be 1/8 of the total flux. So we can say the flux passing through this particular cube is going to be Q over 8 epsilon naught. I repeat what I did. I am using the symmetry. I am constructing this kind using this kind of cubes to make a bigger cube so that this charge become at the center of that bigger cube. To construct the bigger cube using this kind of cubes, we need 8 this kind of cubes so that we can place 4 at the bottom and 4 upside, so that will become bigger cube. So this cube will have a 1/8 share of the total, so hence the flux will become Q upon A epsilon naught. Now let's say there is a second part of the question, and that asks for the flux through, let's say, top face. Now we need to find the flux through the top face. Let's say this is the top face, and we need to find the flux through this face. So again, we can think of something like E dot ds, integration E dot ds. Now since this is open surface, we are not going to put the closed circle there. Now if we take any differential element on the surface, let's say I'm taking this as a differential surface element ds. This ds is going to be point out in the perpendicular direction. And if we draw the field line at this point, so because of this, the field lines is going to be in this direction, so that will be the direction of E. Now if we see carefully, the direction of E and direction of ds are at 90 degree at all the points on the surface. So we can claim to this flux that this is going to be integration E ds cos 90 degree, and we know cos 90 degree becomes 0. That means from the top face of the cube there will be 0 flux passing through. That means there will be not a single field line that will cross this top surface. The field lines simply will be tangentially and touching the surface, and none of them will be crossing, neither going inside nor outside, and the flux becomes 0. We can also have another part. That's the third part, and it says flux through front face. So this time we are using the front face, and let's say that's a front face we are using or we are interested in. From this face, how much flux will be passing through? So we can use symmetry here. We can say from the front face the flux will be equal to same as the flux passing through the bottom face. Because as per this charge is concerned, with respect to this charge, three faces are symmetrically located: the front face, the bottom face, and the face from this side. So since we know the total flux passing through this cube is Q upon 8 epsilon naught, and this flux will be passing through three faces: front face, bottom face, and that face. Now these three will have an equal share because of the symmetry. So we can say this flux is going to be 1/3 of the total flux through this cube, which was Q upon 8 epsilon naught. That means the flux through the front face is going to be Q upon 24 epsilon naught. So if we are asked about the flux through the front face, this is going to be this value. If someone asks flux through the bottom face, the same value. If someone asks the flux from this face, which is backside, this side, so that face will also have a Q upon epsilon for 24 epsilon naught. So this will be the flux through these three faces, and sum of these three faces is total flux. And we have calculated the flux from this top surface is 0. Similarly, the flux through this connected surface will be 0, and from the backside surface will also be 0. That means the three faces connected to this point charge location will have a 0 flux, and three apart faces will have a flux Q upon 24 epsilon naught. So this is again an important example, and using symmetry and Gauss law to find the flux. Here is another example that says charge is located just outside a corner. We need to find flux. Number one part is through the cube, the entire cube. So it's a just outside. When we have a just word, that means it's almost a negligible separation from that thing, right? So from the corners, almost negligible separation is there. So if we need to find the total flux through the cube, so we can again construct the bigger cube by using 8 such cubes. and this will become almost at the center of this entire one, and this cube will have 1/8 of the total shear. So we can say the flux through this cube is going to be 1/8 of the total flux of a point charge, which is Q upon epsilon naught. So our answer remains same, which is Q upon 8 epsilon naught. Now let's say there is another part, second, which says flux through the top face. So in case we need to find the flux through the top face, so this is the top face. Now since this is just outside, so there will be certain field lines which will be crossing, passing through and going inside through this cube, this face, top face, right? So the field lines now are crossing this face, so flux is non-zero. And moreover, E and DS will not be perpendicular all the way. So this time this top face will not have a zero flux. But there has to be this thing. The first part, let's check this first part a bit. It says in the first part we have found the flux through the entire cube, right? So in entire cube, if we are talking about the entire cube, so in that entire cube, let's say rethink about it. The flux through the entire cube, if we are considering, so we should proceed like this: integration E dot ds. Now we know since this charge is outside, so we can take this as a Gaussian surface. If we can take this as a Gaussian surface, so we will find in the Gaussian surface charge enclosed upon epsilon naught. This is how we should proceed. So the charge enclosed is going to be zero. So we will be claiming that total flux through the cube is going to be zero because this point charge is just outside. So there's no charge inside. Moreover, theoretically, how we will be justifying the field lines which are going to be going inside, they must leave outside. So that means whatever the flux is going in, the same flux must be leaving outside. So the plus will be leaving flux, negative will be the entering flux, so total flux will become zero. So the flux through the entire cube is going to be zero. Pardon for that. So that's the first part. Now in the second part, let's have a second part, which we are talking about the from the top surface. Top face. Now if we are considering this top face which we started with, so again, as I said earlier, the flux won't be zero because some field line is going to go inside, but we have found out the flux through the entire cube is zero, right? Now we can say the flux entering from this face and from this face which I'm shading and the face backside, they will be allowing the flux going inside, right? And the total flux, what is going to go through this on this cube, will be entering from these three faces and leaving from all these three faces. So the share of these faces will be 1/3. So we can say the flux is going to be 1/3, and the amount of the flux entering from one face, we can think of the bigger cube. In from the bigger cube, the flux that will be going all the cubes will be Q upon epsilon naught, and this cube will have a share of 1/8. So the total flux that will be entering inside is going to be Q upon 8 epsilon naught. So the flux through each face entering is going to be Q upon 24 epsilon naught. That is ingoing flux, which we can also mention by mentioning minus sign. So that's going to be the flux inside, and we can claim whatever the flux is entering, that must leave from these faces. So if the third part comes for flux through the front face, so can we say the front face is the face which is allowing the flux to go outside, and that flux will be again same as the flux entering from these faces. So it will be again 1/3 of the total flux outgoing. So total flux outgoing is going to be Q upon 8 epsilon naught. So we can say Q upon 24 epsilon naught is going to be outgoing flux through the front face. So in nutshell, we can say the amount of flux entering from this top face and this shaded face is this much, and the amount of flux leaving from front face is this. Same flux will be all the rest of the two surfaces, like bottom face and that side face. So this has to be negative, this has to be positive. We combine them together, so the total flux will become zero. So if the charge is just outside, the net flux will be zero, and ingoing flux be equal to outgoing flux. So that is for the charge located just outside. Can you try a similar equation in which this charge is placed just inside? If we place this just inside, then we can solve for the total flux through the cube, top face and the front face. I'm just giving you a hint. The total flux through the cube will be, you can take the Gauss, this as a Gaussian surface, so this will become Q upon epsilon naught. And similarly, you can connect with this and this. So just try for the equation when this is just inside. And you can write your answer on the comment box. Thank you for watching.